Hey guys, it's Gary with Upton Bass. I wanted to go into a term that a lot of double bassists, violinists, you know, instrument owners hear thrown around by us makers that you're probably like, oh yeah, I know what you mean, but do you? Quartersawn, and how we refer to wood being quartersawn. So beneath me is about 130 to 140 year old piece of sugar maple, much like Abraham Prescott would have used. And our American sister to other trees of the Acer family in Europe, a lot of times referred to as sycamores, not to be confused with American sycamores, but this is an Acer sugar maple from down the road from the barn here in Mystic, Connecticut. All right, so let's take a look at the log. If you see the end of this log as a slice of pizza, here's our crust. Here's the spot where you take your first bite. If I draw the edges of the pizza, here is essentially where we render the piece of wood for, in this case, maple, for a back. The rings of the wood, which we all know as children, we counted the rings to see how old a tree was, the rings of the wood are running like so, right? Obviously, from here to here, there's about 140 of those rings, each one for a year. Plus a little bit of a smudge factor in the middle where we can't quite establish every single year of the tree. I'm going to switch back real quick to a piece of stock from the shop. In this case, we're going to use a top because it's light. A sawyer can take the log and cut full length across the log, which is called quartering, thus quartersawn. These two came out of the spruce tree together like so. So essentially, this would mimic piece one here and piece two here. Interesting note for the bass player. So we've cut the wood out of the tree like so, and we are taking these two pieces of wood, putting them together, which we call joining. So now you can see that the bark side is in fact the center seam of the instrument. So again, the end of the cut here, this bark side, is going to be in the middle. It's going to be in the middle of your top. This is the youngest wood in the growth, and the oldest wood in the tree. There's a layer. I'm not sure we can see it here. There's a layer between where the actual sapwood and the bark are. It's called cambium. That's where nutrition is sent from the rest of the tree down to the roots on the outer section of the cambium. And then on the inner section of the cambium, it actually is the part of the tree that's turning into sapwood, so being actual more hard wood. So as each year passes and a new ring is generated there, this process of growth is happening out here. Not like a lot of people imagine in the middle, back to the top or the back of a bass. So a top is spruce, for an example, or back and sides out of maple. So again, we've got the oldest growth here and the youngest growth here. Book matching. What is book matching? You can see here on this piece of wood, there's some interesting features. I mean, try to see past the chainsaw work and the wedges and the splitting and all the muck. And this, by the way, is coated. I have this coated to slow down the drying process. I want a very slow drying process for stability. But let's say there's a turn in the plank where there's an interesting, you know, who knows if a funny storm twisted the tree, so on and so forth. You wouldn't want to take a piece of wood from here. Imagine this one's from here, and a piece of wood from here and put them together, because they won't match. Book matching is actually using these two pieces where they live right next to each other. See, they're sharing this common ground. So as they're folded out of the tree like so, these guys are sawn out of the tree like so, and then as we bring them out, a sawyer or a bass maker in this case would be careful not to mix these pieces together. It's like keeping cards in a deck of the same suit together. So these guys would get set aside as a set, and as you were cutting through the tree, you'd keep them together so they could be book matched. With any luck, this guy will pop while I'm working on it, but it may not. I have a series of small metal wedges in here, and I'm gonna take this guy on the end to help out one of my wedges. fingers. And we're gonna go further down here. You have a branch coming out of the trunk. Keep in mind what you're looking at, this is, you know, 7.5 foot long. Base top or back. The base back's gonna live probably right here. This branch actually will give us some really cool feature. Hopefully someday I'll be able to show you in another video. You'll have to stay tuned for quite some time though. See you in, you know, maybe like 80 months from now. So if you listen, you can actually hear the wood. Sometimes I drive this splitter in and just wait. Keeping in mind that what we're doing here and what we've done today is we're just starting the quartering process. We're getting the tree into pieces that are manageable, that we can bring inside. Eric and the guys will be able to chop them up. We'll coat the ends, we'll grade them, we'll stack them. And I think, like I might have said earlier, you'll see them turn into Upton Basses maybe in, you know, what, 2025 or something like that. That's it, guys. Let us know if you have any questions or want us to go into further depth about the process of turning a tree into a piece of wood for a base. Thanks.